Well, good afternoon. This is Steve Caddick. I'll just stick my face in here for a minute. We are going to make a banjo bridge today. And here's a few of the tools that we need. T-square, bridge jig, a little hand saw, circle guide, masking tape, couple of files, measuring device, a pencil, calipers, screwdriver, awl, a little piece of sandpaper, pen, X-Acto blade knife, some magnifiers, a band saw. Let me come around this way. My drill press with a special jig. And over in the corner over there is my other drill press with a cross mill table on it. So let's get started. First thing we're going to do is select a little piece of maple and ebony blanks. So I got a box full of them right here. So here's basically just a blank. It's got some ebony on top, straight grained maple on it. And let's get started. These I make in longer pieces and then have a friend of mine cut them on the table saw because I don't have a table saw. 2.5 inches long and 1 inch high, but we're going to cut that down. I'm going to make a 5/8 inch bridge today and let's see how this happens. All right. So first thing we do is I'll take my measuring device, which is just a little ruler, and I'm going to mark 1 inch above the seam, and I'm going to come from that point, I'll come down 5/8 once I put some masking tape on it so we know where we're at. Mark there, put my glasses on so I can see, and connect the dots, and I'm going to put a piece of tape on there. The tape is so I can lay out for drilling, and also so I can see on the bandsaw because it's a little dark in there, and I put a little piece of tape on there so that I can see exactly what I'm doing, and I'm going to come down from that mark 5/8 of an inch. Make my marks, connect the dots, bear with me, I try to be a little bit precise with this. All right, so now there's my marks, and we're going to bring this over to the bandsaw over here, and I'm going to try and cut this around the camera. All right, so I've cut proud of the line. So that I've got my basic height all set here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to bring it over to the sanding station. And I'm going to sand this flush. This is already squared up. My calipers and just check for height to make sure that my height is right. So 5/8 of an inch, I believe, is 625 is my card with all my measurements on it. So 5/8, yeah, 625 thousandths. So we're going to see how close I am. I'm at 6'10", so it's a little shorter. Well, that's a little, that end is a little high, so we're going to just sand it real quick just to bring it down. Let's put the calipers on it again and see where we're at. All right, I'm within 5 or 6 thousandths here, so that's going to be close enough. So now the next thing we're going to do is lay out for the holes. So what I like to do is find the center. Let me move this a little bit and try and zoom in right there. So I'm going to find the center of this bridge. Because it's 2.5, I can set this on a quarter and a quarter, mark my 2.5. Now the other thing I want to mark is string spacing. On this bridge, I'm going to use 7/16 of an inch. So we'll go over 7/16, 2, 4, 6, 7/16, and then we'll go the other way, 7/16, and one more time, 7/16, 7. And I've got my marks for 7/16. This is where the T-square comes in handy. I'm going to just square that up on there. Make vertical lines so that I can get my little cross hatches going. I like to be meticulous. That way everything comes out nice and even and symmetrical. And that takes a little bit of extra effort to do. All right, so now there's my vertical lines on there. You can see those. It might be a little fuzzy here, but you can see the, there they are, vertical lines. Now I'm going to split the difference for the center of the hole. So because this is 9/16, we'll make it 9/16. And I'm going to come down about 5.5 to get it to the middle. Draw a line. And now that I've got the line drawn, you can see, this is hard to do. There it is. My center line, I'm going to drill holes at the cross sections. So with the awl, this is the little awl right here. I'm going to make a little mark right in the center of those lines for the drill. So I've got those little marks made, but before I do that, I want to cut my corners. So we cut the corners by measuring on the ebony side in 1/4 inch and up 1/16. In 1/4, up 1/16, and up 1/16. This is my layout for my fat foot on these bridges. I'm going to call these a fat foot bridge. And then here's the little circle guide. And this gives me the radius that I want. So I can make those little end cuts. You'll see that in just a minute here. Because I do those little end cuts on the bandsaw. And then I use my oscillating sander to get them a little bit better. So we're going back to the bandsaw. And I'm just going to nip off the corners. come over here to the oscillating table here, and I have a little jig. I put this in the jig to keep it flat and flush, and it gives me something to hang on to. Push that in. And there are my corners. You can see those. They're nice and nice and even now. And I have a 16th of an inch ledge on the bottom. And this is where we're going to now drill in the drill press. So I have this little jig here that I built. Two little spacers with a stop block in the back, my drill bit, and a little push block. So what I end up doing is I put that right, just a hair wide. I'll be right back. I just got to sand this slightly. I just sanded the foot slightly. That way I can get it into the jig. It's fairly tight. These sit right up against the stop block, and then, this sits flat, if there's no sawdust in the way. There we go, and now all I gotta do is turn this on and drill a hole. I've already got the distance set. Now I've drilled the holes, and I can take the tape off now because I'm done with the tape. Starting to look like a banjo bridge now. So you can see that I've got my holes nice and evenly spaced on there. And now we're coming back over here to put it into the bridge jig, which is right there. So this is a little device that we made about 40 years ago. It's got the special angles and a clamping mechanism on both sides. There's a side one and a side two. So we mill side one first. Now that goes in the jig. Hold it nice and flush and fairly square. The screwdriver is to tighten the screws. And now we're ready to do a little bit of milling. That's in there nice and secure. So now we're going to come over to the cross mill station here. And I'm going to set this up so that hopefully you'll be able to see this operation. And I won't be in the way. And you'll see how everything works. So the way I've got this set up is in the chuck, I have a flat-bottomed end mill. It's about 3/8 of an inch. And I'm going to mill off material because this cross-milling table has two handles, and you'll see how that operates in 1 second. Now let me just secure that, and here we go. So I put this in the vise, and I put it flush to the jaws, and I just tighten it in. Boom. Now what we got to do is set the cutting depth for the first cut. So I'm going to loosen that. I like to eyeball that one. And tighten up the thing here so that it's not going to go anywhere. There we go, because I'll be back to that in a second. Can you see that? No, you can't see that. So this part of the drill press is where I control my depth of cut. Now you'll see how the mill itself works. Alrighty, here we go. Highest speed possible on the drill press. I try to go steady and smooth with this. I don't want to go too fast because I could chip the wood. It's a nice sharp end mill with, I think it's a 5 blade on the bottom. Well, the first cut is a little shallow. This just kind of cleans the edge of the wood. So now we're going to do some depth. Get it back to my starting point. I do what's called climb milling, so that the rotation of the blade is clockwise and I go counterclockwise into the wood. So now I loosen this. With that, I'm going to do a couple of turns on this, tighten that, and off we go again. So I go about half the depth of the blade, half the depth of the end mill for my how much I take off at one time. Now over here I got to be careful because I want to leave enough material for the foot. And I like to leave it a little heavy on these first couple of passes. Let's go back to the beginning. Loosen this, move that down a little bit, change my head of cut, and do it again. Take one more pass. Not quite as much this time. This is my final pass, and this will be the cleaning pass too, because we don't need to sand this afterwards, because the end mill leaves a nice clean finish, as long as it's sharp. So this is like a cleaning cut, but it's also going to help me get to the depth I want. And this will be the final pass on this side, so now I'm also going to set it up for the thickness of my foot. Okay, that's the end of that side. Let's reset the mill. Some sawdust, and you can see how that all makes it nice and clear. Now let's bring it back over to the bench for a second, where we're going to flip sides. So now what I want to do is just flip the side, take that, loosen this, loosen that. And what I end up doing now, cleaning the sawdust, is I'll take this and I'll flip it end over end. So I got the other side here. And I'll secure that in the jig. I don't like to squeeze it too tight because I don't want to crack the foot. But I like to hold it down so that it's flat, so that now you can see how this actually sits in the jig after the second pass. I want that face flat to the angle in the jig, and then this tight enough so that bridge isn't going to move when we mill it again. So now we mill the second side. If I can get my little thing over here, I'm a little tight on space. And we'll mill one more time. Let me get that even. All right. Blow off some sawdust. Put that back in here. Get it lined up. Make sure it's flat. And bring this over and reset for the first cut. I don't like to take much on the first cuts. I don't want to go too fast with this. So the way these passives work, I'm always climb cutting onto the wood. The fatter wood is being moved against that blade in the right direction so that I get the least amount of chipping and the cleanest finish I can on the wood itself. Take a little deeper cut right now. Now by a deeper cut, what I mean is I might be close to a 32nd of an inch on each pass. I don't want to take a whole lot off. I don't want to stress the wood so it cracks or chips. But it's a nice straight grain maple. And of course, ebony is the densest wood in the world. Leave that foot a little heavy because I still got to do another pass. I'm just feeling the depth, how much distance there is from the top of my jig to the top of the bridge here. And it's still a little high. I tend to go by feel. This should be my final cut. Now my final pass. This gives me the thickness of the foot. So I'm climb milling again against that foot. And that's the end of that. Sawdust out of there. I've got a little feather edge right there. So what I want to do now is bring it back to the bench and show you what we do here to finish the bridge. Almost done. All right, now what we're going to do is take it out of the jig and do some hand work. Not a lot, a little bit. I need to cut the string slots. am I here? There it is. So you can see. So now there's the bridge. I'm going to take the little flat file here. There's a, see that little feather of wood right there? That's right on the edge of the foot. So I just like to relieve that just slightly. Just enough to remove that wood, that feather. I don't really see one on this side, but we'll give it just a slight little rub. All right, now we're going to set it up right here in the vise. Let me see if I can do this with it so that I can work on it. I need my pencil and my little ruler. I'm going to look at the feet to see which one should be near the bridge and which one should point towards the nut. Okay. So this is going to be the base side of the bridge. It should be just about 2 inches, which it is. And so there's my center point. So I want my slots 7/16 of an inch. So I'm going to come over half of that. 2, 4, 6, 7. That should be right about in the middle. Something's moving on me. Sorry. Ah. Legs on my stand here. I'll stand where they need to be. Sorry. All right. So now, let's try that again. So I want the string slots to be in where the solid wood is. So I find the center of that slot, and then I come over 7/16. 7/16 again. And then another 7/16. That'll be where my strings go. And they'll pretty close to where the holes are. So this is a little saw. It's got a 1/10 inch blade on it. Little angle so that the strings angle back to the nut. I mean to the bridge. To the tailpiece, Steve. And then I use the other file. This is a little triangle file, so I can get a nice little groove in there. And I just relief that one. And I actually use a piece of an actual string to file that slot. Now I got another piece, and I'll file the second slot for the G string. The other two I don't use. I need that piece of sandpaper, and I'm just going to just knock a little bit of that off of there. And there we are. A completed banjo bridge. This is what I call a fat foot bridge. As you can see, I've got this nice little fat foot on there. And this will give it nice tonal separation onto the banjo head. A fairly thin top, so it'll be fairly bright. Nice even tapers down to the bottom. And there you go. Steve Caddick's way of making a banjo bridge. Thanks for watching.